Hello, myself is Dr. Ranganathan, senior neurosurgeon from Astakran Hospital. I'm here in Hyderabad. Now today we are going to speak about a problem called Mpox. And previously this was known as Monkeypox, which was detected in the year 1958 in some laboratory monkeys. And that's why the name of the virus. And then of course in the first human case was detected in the year 1970 in an African nation called Congo. And since that time, it has been known as monkeypox, but the WHO has said for some racial reasons, they have an objection to call it as a monkeypox, so they made it as Mpox. So we are going to say now as Mpox only. The interesting aspect, why are you talking about in 2024? That is a very important reason. The WHO World Health Organization has declared this disease as the public health emergency of international concern. Mind you, the WHO declares very rare, is sort of honored. The reason is, in 2022, there were a number of cases, even in India and Kerala, about 27 cases with 10 deaths. And of course, the whole of the African continent was affected. In the year 2024 also, from the starting of this year, in the African continent itself, there are around 11,000 cases and 1,100 deaths. So the monkeypox is spreading very fast. In addition to that, one European country by name Sweden, there's a monkey detected. And our own friends, neighborhood people, Pakistan, they have detected one case as of now. Luckily, we have no case detected, recorded in India this year so far. Now then you can ask me, why are you worried about? Even the government of India is on a high alert. All the borders, where it is, no matter what airports or seaports, who are people coming from other outside the country, mainly the African countries coming from the Pakistan, they are being, what you call, very clearly monitored for any possible symptoms of this monkeypox, which we are going to talk about more. And there are three main hospitals in Delhi. The government of India, Minister of Health have said, Lady Haninga Hospital, Sabdaring Hospital, and Raman Okulaya, specially earmarked for this purpose. Not only that, the Prime Minister of India has seen a meeting, important review meeting about 2 days back, 3 days back. Every state and hospital has been given the importance to recognize this problem and report as and when. And they can understand the importance of things. The reason is, even though there are no cases as of now, particularly with the global travel, the next case can be detected anytime in India. That's not very far. I'm not scaring you, that's a possibility. Now you can ask me, why are you worried about the Mpox or monkeypox? The reason is that the earlier experience in Kerala is not very good. And the same that is particularly the variant now in 2024 in Africa is different. And what it was in 2022 was a different variant. That was called clade 2V. Now people say the virus, the clade 1A, 1V, that is the variant that is being troubling the humanity now. And this comes mostly in children, very easily, and the death rate is 10%. But clade B, earlier in 2022, the death percentage has been 1%, whereas the mortality, death rate is 10%. So that is the dangerous part. And this spreads from individual person to person, or from the secretions on the individual, somebody is affected. The secretions, that means the sweat, the urine, or any of the secretions can get infect the other person who is next door. Somebody is living in the same room, somebody is living in the same house, using the same cloth, medicines, utensils, there is a possibility. So that spreads very rapidly. That is the main worry. And as I said, mortality is very high. And the symptoms are the fever, back pain, throat pain, and then of course, very significant weakness, malaise. Most important are blisters. And you recall, in the days of smallpox, we haven't seen smallpox in this generation, but smallpox was a big problem in India as well. And luckily, smallpox has been eradicated totally, completely from this country. That time, it used to call them as pox. Pox means blisters. And the blisters used to start on the day one to day two of the fever. And most importantly, they used to persist for about 4 weeks, 5 weeks. And then they heal. But of course, they become leaving black marks, sometimes pox, some pep inside in the lesions, in the skin. And then they're very itchy. Now, these are the lesions which are very, very troublesome. In the smallpox days, suppose the lesions are in the eye, people used to become blind. Luckily, that sort of cases are not recorded. But now, mainly the lesions are seen in the palms and soles. And the third 2B, which was there in 2022, the main reason was the sexual contact. Gay people, bisexual people, and abnormal sex. That is spread like that. That's why the lesions in those people are in the genitals, anal area, mouth, or the throat. These blisters were seen. Now they are seen less. So the present clade is a different clade. Suppose the monkeypox has come. And what do? We have to take our precautions. People who are in that area, we have to keep away and where to come up. Be in touch with the secretions of the vesicles, what are called the blisters. We should be very careful. We should inform the health authorities as far as possible. The biggest hurdle for this problem is that there are no significant medicines for that. But there is a medicine by name antiviral medicine, which is used for smallpox. The scientists say that you can use it. It's called picoviramate. But that is not very, very common. The tablet is available. The vaccines are very scarce. Still, in this country, we don't have the monkeypox vaccine. People are working on. And there are three vaccines, LC16, the vaccine LC16, and also there is another vaccine by name Orthopoxvirus. Because the problem is, one more small problem here I will tell you is the economic and geographical aspect. I'm sorry to say, when the problem has been rampant for years together in what you call the African continent, which is a neglected backward continent of the world, and the scientists from there, by those areas, people have been requesting, please do some more research, do develop some new medicines, because this is very rampant, killing thousands and thousands of people. But nobody has paid attention. It was in the deaf ears. Only when the rich nations and started problem, that is in 2022, some interest and some research, suddenly the funds which were not coming for 60 years, this have funds for the research of Mpox started flowing in. If the concept has me, oh, that is a neglected area, some backward area, this one, Africa, this is somebody else's problem, and why are you bothered about it? Which is not correct. Now then, if that is so, the WHO, why it's declared as the international emergency? What is the public health concern of international emergency? Because now the spread is very fast. The reasons are quite a few. The global travel has increased, and particularly the urbanization and the man and the animal conflict has increased. The animals where they have to live. And one of the reasons why I've talked about the animal conflict is animals like monkeys or rodents, they scratch the individual or they bite the individual. And in people who are particularly, they eat the uncooked or the improperly cooked meat of these animals, also can be a monkeypox. So these are the problems. So the urbanization has taken away all the important greenery. So the animal, the interface between the animals and the human beings has become very close up. So that is again leading to the spread of this disease. And mind you, it's not the last. I'm sorry to say, I'm not scaring you. I'm not giving what you call a bad warning. But the COVID has gone, but now monkeypox and some other virus can come unless we take all the precautions. And the particular the climate change, as I said, the global travel, global warming, the urbanization, felling of the trees, and the man and animal interface, unless these are taken care, we are heading for more and more problems. And particularly in the urban areas and all, these are very common. So the concept that there's somebody else's problem only in the Africa It's not in the rich countries and all. I'm sorry to say that in the news, there are news trickling now that the rich nations like the European nations and all, and particularly the America, they have stockpiled the vaccines in these countries, hoping for some, a pandemic like the COVID. And imagine what has happened in COVID, what we talked about. How generous the government of India has been to give the vaccines to countries like Brazil and our neighborhood friends, irrespective of the political differences. And that's what the humanity should be. That's what the whole world should be whenever there is a crisis comes, rather than for the financial reasons. So, Mpox is a threat. We have to be very vigilant. And the distance between Pakistan and India, not very far off. If it has come into Pakistan, because there is a gentleman who's traveling from Africa and landed in the Pakistan, Lahore, and subsequently his whereabouts are not traced yet till today, but there is a case recorded. So we have to be vigilant. Government of India has taken a very cooperative thing, because the example in Kerala, word. COVID time, particularly the monkeypox also, Kerala state have done extremely well. The isolation, contact tracing, and they have done a phenomenal job. So the same thing can be replicated here also, and all the precautions need to be taken. There are no medicines, the tablets, of course, available partly, but the vaccines need to be imported. Even for the government of India, they are not yet producing on a large scale the monkeypox vaccine, and the problem is threatening. We have to be very, very careful. Thank you.